So, Donnie.
Yeah.
I read this interesting article the other day, and apparently, statistically speaking, 3 out of every 100,000 people are cannibals.
Now that is interesting, Drew. That's very interesting. That's a lot of cannibals, though. Mm-hmm. I don't like that. Mm-hmm. I don't like that high number. But, although, are we talking about cannibals that are just doing it just to get off, just get their kicks and giggles? Or are we talking about people who have to eat them to survive, like they're stranded on the top of Mount Everest and their partner froze to death and they have to cook them over fire and eat them that way?
Yeah, we're talking both. There's survival both cannibals okay. and legit cannibals that get them from kicks.
I feel a little bit better about that now. I gotta say, because I understand the people on Everest doing that. You gotta live. You gotta survive. Mm-hmm. Now, that is also interesting because I also read an article, because I read, and it said that a human life is worth approximately 75 grand.
That's crazy.
75 grand.
Well, now it could kind of relate to these cannibals. Because that's like a $75,000 steak just sitting there.
It's just lying there.
You'd be an idiot not to use it. On the ground,
fresh, just waiting for you.
Oh, that sounds delicious.
Some seasoning. You put some pepper on there.
Oh. Mm. You'd be an idiot not to take advantage of that. That's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
You would be a moron.
We Dem Boys! How about we crack this cast can open with some news?
News!
How about some news?
News! Let's get some news in here.
Hey! Let's get news! News!
News! Alright, apparently Donald Glover is playing Lando Calrissian in the new Han Solo.
I heard that, dude.
I'm excited about it. He fits it.
Lando Calrissian!
On Reddit, they had a picture of him in school, like I assume a high school picture, wearing a Star Wars shirt, and the title was like, Little Did He Know. That's really funny because, you know, he clearly was a fan back then. Like, what person actually thinks that...
I like that guy.
They're going to have that kind of role.
Yeah.
He's a hell of a talent.
Hell of a talent. Yeah.
He's like an actor. He does stand-up. He
can
a
be
rapper.
Serious. He can be funny.
It's crazy.
He can be a scientist. He was in that Matt Damon movie.
Martian. That's the one.
He was really good at that.
Physicist. Very smart guy.
Super smart guy.
Physicist.
Yes.
I mean, it's like official, so I don't, that's cool. Approved. I have no issue with that.
Yeah, that's all right.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 trailer dropped.
Saw it.
You guys saw it?
I liked it.
Yeah. Nothing new.
All Drax, pretty much, which I liked.
Yeah. All Drax.
Some people dance.
No Groot.
Oh, there was a little bit of Groot.
There was. I missed the Groot.
I missed the baby Groot.
I missed baby Groot.
At the end, not only was he baby, but he was in a uniform.
Oh.
And he's on Rocket Raccoon's back.
Oh,
you gotta wait till
okay.
the end of the credits of that trailer, man.
Yeah, it's where Rocket Raccoon.
Damn,
shoots
I
that
do.
Whole
I didn't see that.
Shoot,
let's click to the next video.
Yeah.
So you saw the extended Logan trailer. We got you covered on the Guardian Galaxy.
Cover those gaps. Get those gaps.
Comprehensive coverage.
We're hitting on all cylinders.
We're good. We're good. We got this.
Every mole
nothing
that pops
gets
up
past us.
Nothing.
It's a tight knit. Operation.
Power Rangers dinosaurs look too much like the Transformers Dinobots. I'm saying it.
You said it.
Wow, that's
you know
official.
What? I have to agree with
I'm
it.
Saying
it's
it.
On record. Right.
I would agree.
Pussies,
with
they could have made it look cool as fuck. Put that Triceratops on some wheels.
It's wheels.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Treads.
Treads.
Yeah,
they had the treads when they turned the tank.
Oh,
the
yeah, that's
Megazord.
Right. They
Drew just watched the history of the Megazord not that long ago.
I don't know if I like that.
What? You don't know if you like the wheeled Triceratops?
Treaded Triceratops? I think there's something else that was like that. I didn't really like that. Because the saber-toothed tiger was the other leg, and it had legs.
Yeah, well, it has to. It has to go super fast.
No, man, I'm going to go on record and take issue with these treads.
You don't like the treads?
But those treads can go fast.
But you don't like the scene when it's hauling ass down the desert, and it's kicking up all that dirt, and it's just like, yeah!
Well, I get it. It's fine. It's
so cool.
It's fine, but I'd rather see some tiny legs.
I'm not gonna say. I'd say a combination would be cool.
But yeah, tiny legs of a mammoth. Maybe he could. Okay, how about we
that's
meet
true,
in the
did.
Middle here, and he could have like several tiny legs.
No, dude.
The
Triceratops
no.
had
no.
legs. It had legs, but also it transformed into treads. Because remember when they formed the tank?
It didn't have legs.
Fuck
it. It only had wheels.
Oh,
and, like,
yeah, it went like this.
And, like,
that's all it
treads.
Did.
Yeah.
Okay, it did all
its head
treads,
would come up
yeah.
and shit, and its tail would come up.
That's right. It would, yeah.
That was a mistake. sorry, tangent.
The Guardians of the Galaxy trailer. I don't know, I'm kind of bummed out. It didn't show anything. You just saw the same old shit. Yeah, this is
just a super teaser. I think they just finished.
They don't need to show you anything. Yeah. I think at this point, you're going to go see it no matter what. They should just have like a basic
vanilla trailer. Classic.
I know.
Fuck you. You'll see it.
I want a little taste of something new, you know?
I know.
You think they're going to bring in Thanos?
I mean, that guy's got to start showing up, like, more.
Maybe stealing, or if he just starts grabbing the Infinity Gems, and they run into him that way somehow. Or
well, he just has the glove at this point, right?
Yeah, because he's got to go out and get those gems, dude.
Well, he's in Guardians of the Galaxy 1, so he's got to be on this one.
Yeah, I think he will be.
That's cool. Kurt Russell's going to be a planet. That's neat.
You go the living fucking planet. That is what I'm most excited for.
Dude, I want to see that.
And they said there's a planet that they land on in the trailer that's actually that planet.
Oh, is it the forest planet?
I think so, yeah. There's like a name for it.
Holy shit.
Yeah. But I think what they're going to do with it is Kurt Russell isn't actually going to be the planet. He's going to be like the wizard in Wizard of Oz. He's going to like be controlling the planets.
Like a physical manifestation of the planet.
I just want to see his face in that planet. Yeah.
I know. I want a living planet too.
Yeah, planet like Kurt with Russell's head. Face just on a planet.
I want to see him walking around like, I am the representation of ego.
Yeah, no, I want his face on the planet.
That's lame. That's a cop out.
Yeah.
Come on, take some risks.
I have a feeling that's what they're going to do because he's also Peter Quill's dad.
And they also got to show Kurt Russell's face.
Yeah, they got to show that whole hot body.
You got to.
I want to see some Kurt Russell pectorals.
Boiled hot dogs.
Or I'm
boiled
going home, or I'm walking out.
Getting out of there.
I want to see some Kurt Russell butt. Some of that Russell butt, or I'm out. Yeah, well, we didn't see any of that, so, you know, I'm going on with my life. Next up on the list, Logan trailer.
Yes.
This is the big. This is the big tamale.
Looks all good. Right. Doesn't look like he's going to be wearing that mask.
No, he's not going to be. He's even less likely to wear that mask now.
But one thing I was thinking about, what if there are flashbacks?
Yeah, that'd be cool. I'd see
it. I would take that.
Okay.
I would take that.
I'm
going to
see it.
You know, what if there are like other X-Men in there? What if Deadpool's in the flashback?
Did you hear... Oh, sorry, that's a bit probably on the news later on.
No, probably not.
About Deadpool's? This is the last thing. The guy who directed Deadpool walked out recently due to creative differences with Ryan Reynolds.
Oh!
Yo.
Oh, no. I wonder if that's good or bad.
I trust Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, I kind of do. Like, I almost feel like they probably got into an argument about conflicting stories with Deadpool.
Spoken.
stop it.
Sorry, troll just ran into the room.
Oh, God.
It's a house troll.
Get out of here, troll.
It's nothing to fear
over here. Drop it in.
How was the troll running away, Tony?
You should probably kick that over before you.
Yeah, my system.
Yeah. Cool. Okay.
All right. Logan.
Dude,
awesome. I think it looks good. You don't like it?
Really?
Hey, man.
I'm pretty.
What did you not like about
it? I'm kind of worried about it. Well, first, I mean, Professor X, what the hell is he doing?
How is he possibly still alive?
But I don't care. I like Patrick Stewart, Professor Xavier.
For
whatever reason, I'm sure I'm fine with. I want to see more of him.
Job. I'm not complaining about St. Patrick.
But don't
Sir Patrick Stewart.
Yeah, he's a knight.
Don't mutants live longer than normal humans, though?
That's what it sounds like in there.
Because I thought they're just smarter with the X gene, and they live longer.
Are you talking about like in the comics?
Yeah.
So I never ran across that, but I
thought that was true. I don't know, maybe.
You've always been kind of like the grand wizard that I've, you know, YouTube
grand wizard
of comics that I was.
Like a KKK leader?
Oh, Jesus. No, I'm sorry.
Donovan, you know the KKK, right?
I'm sorry.
I told you not to hang out with those guys.
You know they got free food.
The KKK leader comes
too. They get that liquor.
You should see the spread they set out.
I apologize.
It's a
fine spread.
I was a
lovely spread.
I was envisioning Gandalf.
Fried foods and macaroni and cheese, dude.
He's like King Wizard.
I don't know what to say now. I'm afraid I'll say something.
I'll catch you. Oh, that's racist.
You got me spun.
You mean like
you
the Nazi soldiers?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, like
Donnie knows a lot about
like the dungeon master of my comics.
Okay,
upbringing. You guys especially were the ones who introduced me to that at a young age.
Yeah. Yeah, you've always known, like, those kind of nuanced facts.
I like those.
Yeah.
I
like those. You're like, hey, you guys know.
Those little tidbits, yeah, those things, little nuggets. Mm-hmm.
Things that make it interesting.
And maybe that's true. Maybe, like, mutants have... I kind of remember reading something about mutants having, like, being... better, more adequate as something.
And having
I thought they were too.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure I'm almost positive they're smarter. Like, I'm almost positive.
Probably.
Every one of them, though, is smarter than the average human.
Yeah, maybe generally. You know, maybe there's like a bell curve. Okay. But, like,
okay. I believe it.
Man, I'm proud of that.
That was good.
But yeah, I think, like, it's just, you know, most of them are. But there's probably some that are on the far end, like Xavier, some on the other end, like the Blob.
That's interesting. Looks like they're all dying off. I think it's the Legacy Virus.
Oh.
You guys know about the Legacy Virus? Because who develops the Legacy
Caliban.
Virus?
Right?
Mr. Sinister.
Okay. I'll draw
Caliban, but Caliban, I think, has a role, because he, like, works with Mr. Sinister, I think.
He's, like...
In the comics.
I don't know shit about him, but... I remember, like, I saw him in the trailer, I'm like, that's not the Caliban I remember. Caliban looking like a Hulk, almost.
Yeah, yeah.
But...
Well, that's the Caliban that, got infused with Apocalypse's technovirus. Like, Apocalypse got a hold of him, and he became a horseman.
Okay.
And he got he made him all buff and shit.
Okay.
That's and he gave him, like, the super agility, and he could, like, crawl on walls and shit.
But he's normally pretty small.
Yeah, he's, like, he's in the Morlocks when he first started out. He was really skinny and scrawny. He was in the animated series, I think.
Yeah,
he had, like,
was.
Really big eyes.
Okay.
Like,
Storm's friend.
Yeah. But he did, like, that's the one I mostly remember. Anytime I think of Caliban, that's the one I call back to.
Okay.
Like, really huge... buff Horseman of Apocalypse Caliban.
Yeah, that's the one I always say. Yeah, horns on his head.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But don't call him a horn
he's
head.
Like red and white. Mm-hmm. He's played by Stephen Wright? Is that guy's name?
He's a British actor.
He's in
a lot of things. Yeah, he had something to do at The Office. He's working with, you know, Ricky Gervais a lot. You see him on, there's a few Netflix shows I think that he's in.
Yeah. Yeah, he's all right, I guess. I hope they have, like, a lot of Sinister and, like, Legacy Virus.
Have you heard who's going to play Sinister?
No.
Yeah, I don't know.
John Hamm.
Ooh.
That'd be sweet.
Oh, yeah.
He better look like in the comics. If he's not... If he doesn't look like that at all...
If he doesn't have that, like, upside-down Widow's Peak goatee, he'll be pissed. And that diamond on his forehead, better fucking be there.
It better be red.
And those ribbons...
And the mascara.
His ribbon cape, yeah. Mascara.
Maybe
it'll go deep. White face.
Don't fuck it up.
Gloves. Really high boots that go up to his thighs.
Yeah, I never liked those, though. Maybe we could skip those.
Thigh-high boots.
Skip regular shoes. They got the Reavers, like those guys. The guy with the robot arm?
Yes.
In the trailer?
Yes.
That's like a big... He's on the cover of a pretty popular X-Men comic. He's holding a torch with two wolves in front of him. Is that ringing bells?
No.
It's that guy, though. He's like the leader of the Reavers. I guess they're just pretty much humans. But it doesn't look like they really... I mean, they look like enhanced with cybernetics, like his arm.
Because
Reavers are like cyborgs.
Is that what Lady Death touches?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, she's a Reaver, yeah.
Gotcha, that group.
Mm-hmm.
Lady Death Strike? Or
Death Strike,
yeah.
They're in the cartoon. The guy with the...
Right.
Half his body is Tank Treads.
Yeah, that dude.
And he has a gray mohawk.
Hell yeah.
His name is Bonebreaker.
Bonebreaker.
Yeah, we've
dude,
talked about him.
Yeah.
Because there's a figure? Is there a figure coming out of him?
No, there's an older
figure.
I will not be buying that figure.
I'm going to pass. Ever.
Don't like those kind of treads. Those kind of treads are not... It doesn't work.
Especially not on a triceratops.
I don't like that kind of stupid design.
Especially on a triceratops.
No, it's cool.
That's an example
of blue-ass triceratops.
All right.
It's just a leg, man.
Perfect.
It's just a
leg.
Makes
sense.
I don't know if you guys have ever seen a triceratops, but that's not...
Some of them I've seen, at least, dude, some of them I've seen a lot of fucking triceratops.
All right,
I guess I need to look back in the history.
No one knows what they look like.
How do you
just guess?
This
is a theory, Drew. Okay, ask questions.
Jeez, yeah, just a theory.
Do some research once in a while.
I got some shit. You need to read.
You have no question about the Tyrannosaurus climbing out of a volcano. No questions about that. It's Those treads just gotta go.
The Tyrannosaurus Rex natural habitat is a volcano.
Everyone knows this is known. Duh. Everyone knows
it's that. Common sense. anyway, back to Logan. I don't know. You guys are pumped?
I am.
You guys excited?
I'm ready to see it. He doesn't look like Wolverine to me, though.
I don't know. I'm like hesitant about it, but I'm hesitantly optimistic. The trailer was great.
The trailer was cool. I think we've seen all this. Like, they fucked up by not putting him in the costume a long time ago.
They did, yeah.
Yeah, and they're doing Old Man Logan in the comic. It had tons of, like, Marvel characters that they can't put in now. Hulk, Captain America.
They're rushing it. Yeah. Like, I don't
know.
Maybe
they are.
I mean, maybe they could work with it a little bit. But, okay, here is my main concern. It's basically Wolverine losing his powers again, and that's what happened in the second.
I know, dude.
I hate that shit.
The Wolverine loses.
I do too.
Adamantium.
I can't stand that.
Yeah.
They
can
took Spider-Man's powers away.
Yeah, that's in Spider-Man 2.
That's why the comics.
I want to see them with the powers.
That's why the comics are always so much better, because you get to enjoy them with their functional powers. Whereas movies, it's always about their abilities being taken away at some point.
Yeah, they've done so many.
Hate
the
that.
New Ninja Turtles movie that came out.
Dark Knight Rises.
X-Men First Class. Yeah,
we could just go on, dude.
Keep going. Right, yeah. That's how Beast turned blue. Backfired on him.
Yeah. Now he can just be Beast when he wants to and not when he... No, the whole part of Beast is that he's stuck. Dr. Hank McCoy is stuck as the Beast.
Yeah.
It's like the thing.
Yeah, I like it. Yeah,
you can't,
it is.
There is no getting away out of it. Like,
and that does not rock.
It does not.
It does not rock.
It is not clobbering time.
No, it is not.
No, it's clobbering your emotions time.
I can't think of any news.
Yeah. I mean, the Logan, I'm kind of cautious.
Wonder Woman Day
too.
Was Friday.
Yeah.
Wonder Woman Day, 75 years old, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
is she
really?
Kayak? Yeah.
I think the UN, like, did something...
Yeah,
did they all dress up as Wonder Woman?
Well, she'd been nominated as, like...
Ambassador?
Some kind of ambassador, yeah.
A lot of people got...
Women's empowerment.
Yeah. A lot of people got upset because it was like, she's over-sexualized.
She's white and she's over-sexualized. And I agree to the costume aspect of that to a degree for sure. But she's more than just what she looks like as a character. She means something. Like,
people who don't know anything about her probably are complaining about that.
Maybe. Yeah, like her as a character,
or more
she
than
means
others.
So much. Like,
yeah,
not just to girls, like boys too. I was a big fan of her as a kid, still am.
I really like modern Wonder Woman.
Oh yeah,
she's really cool. Like really huge,
like comics
tall
was the one
warrior.
I was. Yeah,
yeah, Jim Lee's Wonder Woman,
almost 7
yeah,
foot
man.
Tall Amazon warrior.
Yeah.
Like hell yeah.
She always like towered over Superman and Batman.
I
she
love
did,
that.
Yeah.
That was my favorite
she's
type.
Huge. She's strong.
In Final Frontier, was it not Final Frontier, but New Frontier or something like that? The
yeah, New
movie,
Frontier. Yeah.
Lucy Lawless played the voice of her.
Yeah.
It was really good.
I wasn't a big fan of the movie, but she did a very good job as a voice.
But yeah, I kind of like her sort of fish out of water sort of thing going
kinda
on.
Like
she
Thor
licked the ice cream.
Her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she's like, I love ice cream. She, mm-hmm. she tastes like
another. Throws the ice cream on the floor.
Another.
I want another fresh lick.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, that's it for news.
Get out of here.
Yes. Well, we're waiting to see more trailers, guys. And then we'll give you more.
All right. Yeah.
Especially Guardians of the Galaxy. I better see something else.
I kind of like
that. I guess it can wait.
I agree with you.
It can wait. I'm just excited
about
it. I really want to see something.
I mean, it is. Did see the same thing. You saw him put his mask on. You saw Gamora walking around.
Yeah,
and
she was like kind of charging with her sword and stuff. That
yeah,
cool.
That looked kind of cool, but they didn't really. But it's just like.
They're just abstract different
teaser.
Shots, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it wasn't supposed to be anything.
Just a teaser. I'm excited it's coming out.
It's gonna be good, dude. You know it's gonna be good. Need to watch the first one again sometime.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I haven't seen it in a while.
It's classic.
A little bit.
Yeah. Anyway, our main event for today is talking about, you guessed it, Spider-Man villains.
Where do you have active spider grudge?
Ooh, wow, that's good. Spider Grudge.
Spider
Grudge.
Spider Grudge. Spider Grudge. Spider Man.
Yeah, last time we talked about Batman villains.
It's time to go back to Marvel for a little while. We're going to talk about some goddamn Spider-Man villains.
Yeah, and I guess we just kind of thought of all the ones. I just kind of sat down and looked up a few, but I mostly just thought of ones that I really liked.
Spider-Man is like the only villain, like hero, that I think has as many good villains as Batman has villains.
I think that's a similarity they share.
It defines these characters.
They have some. I think those two characters have some similarities.
Oh, for sure.
But I think that is one. Like, they just have these really crazy personal villains.
Yeah, and they're all unique and interesting, and you can kind of agree with some of them.
Cool costume designs.
Yeah.
They have cool costumes.
Just unique concepts for each of them. So I'm going to sink my lizard teeth into this.
Belly!
Yeah. Take a bite out of these.
Yeah.
Where's Belly?
I think the first one...
In my arm. And my left arm. Where is that at? If you find my arm, my name is Dr. Connor.
It fell off. Let me take my injection. It'll just grow back.
But then it'll fall off again. It's really disappointing.
I can never get this thing right. You don't know how
my
hard
wife
it is.
My wife is so pissed off at me.
Yeah, not to leave me at the kids. Spider-Man's beating me up all the time.
Can't get any work done.
First thing, I turn everybody else into lizards, and then I'm cool.
That's because we're talking about the lizard.
You're all the weirdos. You need to look like me.
You guys love being a lizard. It's awesome.
So sweet. We're cold-blooded. We can swim real good.
I always like lizard. I like his lab coat. I like his purple pants.
I love that lab coat all torn up and his lab in the suit.
Oh, he's always so mad in it, too.
He was.
He's always so upset running around in that lab coat.
He was. He's got so much stuff he's got to get done.
He didn't take it off, though. He left it on. He's like,
he's a professional.
He's got shit to do. He ain't got time to try and take it off.
Yeah. That's what I hated about the Amazing Spider-Man.
They had to make him all naked. But they never give him penises.
It's like
they give him this Ken doll thing. It's really weird.
It was weird. Yeah, you can't do that. It was a pain.
Show me that dick. It doesn't scare us, okay? Fucking Dr. Manhattan. That was a good movie. Watchmen.
Yeah.
His penis was in it the whole time.
Yeah,
be an adult, okay? It's a penis. Around. Get over it.
It's anatomy. Don't be afraid of your penis.
Jesus.
Stop.
Wiener's out.
We all got him.
Yeah, I wish they had a lab coat. I like that. I like that
look. It's all shredded up.
He's always trying to. Really, my biggest memory of that guy is seeing him in the animated series when he had that big laser. He's walking around in the suit.
What is that lizard doing? With a goddamn laser.
It's Spider-Man.
He's trying to turn everybody else into lizards all the time.
He's always trying to do that.
I guess so he can. But he's just going to turn back to Dr. Connors. He's trying to permanent. Because. He has like a dual personality. Yeah. Like the lizard wants to get rid of Connor.
It's kind of like Two-Face.
The experiments he's done on himself.
Yeah.
He can't. It's this lizard, like this primal part of his brain that keeps talking to him all the time.
I liked him though. I've always liked him. He's one of the more entertaining ones for sure.
That is an amazing origin story.
It is a great fucking
It's personal. It makes sense. Like Donnie was saying.
Yeah, it is. And it's just like his story with him and his wife and his kid.
You feel for him. And he's an amputee.
Yeah.
Like, that sucks.
It's a disaster, you know? He was trying to do good, but it just... And he was trying to, like, do something incredible for just humanity in general.
Yeah, because he had, like, those rats that were missing arms.
Yeah,
he
has the best intentions.
Yeah, he felt sorry for him, I think.
The best intentions.
But hey, you know,
it
kind of worked. He did grow his arm back.
And he murdered a bunch of people.
Murdered a few people.
Maybe he could
turn a few people into lizards, but
he never did that as a one-armed Dr. Connors.
He didn't. He's just in the university teaching class.
I'd say he's making the situation worse by doing that. Just for an arm? Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Come on.
If it was just sitting there, he might as well eat it.
Yeah. It's worth $75,000, what I hear.
It's a lot of money.
He's talking to Donnie earlier.
That's a whole arm.
Dude, I tell you about that article.
Because I'd give me some long pork.
Oh, long pork.
I'm sorry. What?
Nothing, no. I made a statement and just stared at you.
Was it the lizard like
Spider-Man?
I'm sure you said.
Wasn't long pork?
Yeah.
He's talking about human meat.
Long pork is the name.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because they say it's sweet.
It's a
sweet to your teeth.
It's a sweet meat. It goes with the good Chianti.
Not interested in it, though.
No, I'm not into that.
No matter how valuable it is.
I don't care.
Wasn't the Lizard like in the first Spider-Man comic? Wasn't he the first villain?
I remember it was early on. Because he was like
issue 3 or something.
He's early on for sure.
He's early on, but Spider-Man, his first villains were really dumb.
Yeah, they all looked stupid.
And none especially of them were
Lizard,
like,
because he was just... He was like a normal dude,
yeah,
but with scales, really
basic, yeah.
But like his, it was like stupid. It was like there's one where J. Jonah Jameson, like, paid someone to invent this robot, and he's sitting in his office controlling it, and the robot has a screen, and it's J. Jonah Jameson's face.
That's ridiculous.
And then he's chasing Spider-Man. So like the first, because like, I read the first like 100 or so. And I know.
Yeah.
And but like, oh, there's like Kangaroo Man.
Yeah, he's on my list. Oh, yeah. Okay,
So hey, it's really early Spider-Man comics were really awful. They didn't get good until Captain Stacy died. And then Gwen Stacy died, and then it got really good.
Interesting.
Yeah, that was a big that was a big fucking turning point.
Yeah. That really like fucked up Peter.
Oh,
Peter's never been the same since.
No. It's true.
No, he has not been the same since.
And Gwen Stacy was killed by, I think, the next villain we should talk about.
Oh,
Green Goblin.
Goblin.
I think we should kind of just talk about other goblins in general.
Goblins. Let's talk about goblins.
I love the goblins, man. The goblins are...
Get on your gliders.
Really cool.
Get your feet in them. Light them up.
Put them in there. Get your... Get your... Finger lasers ready.
Finger lasers ready.
Your sparkle fingers.
Your what do they call the pumpkin grenades? What do they call
The pumpkin bombs.
Pumpkin bombs.
I love
them. Get them arm.
He's got all these different kinds in his pouch.
Gobble, gobble.
Norman Osborn almost shares a last name with me.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Minus the E, which makes it evil.
You a goblin? You a goblin, bro?
No, dude.
Not a goblin?
No.
He has a U in his name. No, he doesn't.
He has an E. He
does just
he,
an
no.
E at the end.
I have the E at the end. He does not. His is just O-S-B-O-R-N.
I thought it was O-U-R-N.
Nope.
Shit. I should know that.
Hmm.
I don't think so. I was looking in my research.
Okay, no, that's fine.
Because I was like, oh, it's exactly like mine except for the E.
I think that's right. He was kind of stupid at first, too, because he didn't have a glider. He had, like, a broomstick.
Yeah
the stupid, really like, dumb. Yeah, fuck that shit. Get that out of my face.
Yeah,
I want that glider.
That glider is, like, my favorite part about the goblins.
And it looks like a bat, which is cool.
Shoots missiles out of it.
Shoots missiles.
And they all have it, and they'll have, like, different style ones. Like, Demo Goblin has
the
fire.
He's
just flying on, like, a fire eagle. That's so cool.
It is so awesome, dude. I love that thing.
And for some reason, it, like... It's as palatable for that to be facing a spider as a clown to face a bat. It's like for some reason very complementary.
They do complement
in some way.
They keep bothering Spider-Man.
Goblins, because
it kind of went along with like that kind of Halloween aspect.
Yeah.
Spider-Man,
yeah.
About goblins and you know.
There's kind of something else that kind of seemed like that to me too. I mean, there's like Vulture.
Yeah,
Jackal.
Yeah,
it's kind of like
it's got a lot of animal rhino.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. I love. I want to talk about rhino and scorpion in this for sure.
Somewhere. Definitely, they're all really
because they tie into each other kind of well in their circumstance.
I kind of like Hobgoblin. I think his
I love Hobgoblin.
Design is really cool.
Love that color scheme. Love the concept of him.
Yeah, I like his cape, his cowl, and cape.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they all have that kind of scaly pants.
Like Captain America.
Yeah. The boots with the giant rims.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. The what do they call that? A shackle. It's like pirate lingo.
Shackle bell.
No.
They have their pouches.
Dude, they got the pouches where they keep the pumpkin bottles.
They got their caps.
Yeah.
Well, Green Goblin's the only one with a cap, I guess.
Hobgoblin had one too. He wasn't just bald up there.
He had a cowl.
Right,
they all have like heads. Demo Goblin just had like a raggedy.
Yeah, that raggedy cowl.
Demo Goblin started off with as a Hobgoblin, didn't he? And then he turned into Demo Goblin.
I thought he was just a straight demon.
He is. He turned into a demon.
Oh,
because
he died.
Inferno.
Turned
him into a demon.
That's right. Turned him into a demon, and he's coming out with these black pumpkin bombs that he throws, and covered Spider-Man all that goop, and he's like, "Oh, it's so dark and cold.
Yeah.
Oh my god!"
It's like black tar.
Do you see that traumatic shit that happens to Spider-Man costume? God damn!
Insane shit that damages you emotionally.
Just deep down to your core. It's something you can't even comprehend.
That's not something coming back.
No.
That's a stone like, that can't
he's
be that.
He's getting hit with that stuff all the time.
Swashbuckling boots.
Oh, okay.
Got
now
it.
Now I see the shackle. Yeah, okay.
Got it.
Swashbuckling.
Got it. Yeah, I was like, shackle.
Reeled that one in.
That's what they are. You're getting it. You're getting it.
He's got it.
Had to go get it real
honing
quick.
In on
it.
It.
Saw it out there.
In the distance.
I'll be right back. We'll get that.
They got that?
Let me get that.
Which is your favorite Hobgoblin?
Oh, see, I can't go that far. I don't know the difference.
I think...
I just know of Ned Leeds and the first one that was a costume... or the fashion designer.
Yeah, that's
really
what I knew.
I don't know the difference between them, really. What's your favorite one?
Donnie, what's your favorite?
Yeah,
do all your research.
Good question. I think I like Norman Osborn. I think he's the best goblin.
Oh, we're talking about all of them?
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah,
I
go with him too, for sure.
I thought you were talking about just Hobgoblin, but yeah, Norman Osborn.
Green Goblin.
He really has this, because that guy, the thing I like about that guy is he's so low key, but then when he loses his shit, he loses it.
New York knows it.
Yeah, dude. And like, I remember when he was in charge of the Thunderbolts in Thunder Mountain in Colorado.
Yeah.
And like, one day, no one had seen the goblin forever, and one day he just loses it because of Spider-Man, and he's flying through the mountain as Green Goblin, killing so many people, just random workers that work there, and
God,
he killed
the worst.
One of the Thunderbolts.
Dude's out of his mind, and he's like, he's like a bit, like a really...
savvy businessman.
Yeah, savvy businessman, he's really up there, but he's just nuts.
He is, like, not even split personality, he's just... He's like got something that he can barely keep under control.
Yeah.
And it just...
I think Willem Dafoe did a pretty good job portraying that
aspect.
Yeah. He was.
Like barely holding something back, you know.
Just about to snap at any second.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Really kind of like vicious, like soulless
really
kind of person.
Very tightly wound.
Yeah. No, yeah, I think Green Goblin's a tremendous OG. And he's like, everything I look at always says Green Goblin is Spider-Man's arch enemy.
Yeah,
I think so.
I've always thought that he
was the... Because I think people a lot of times think Venom. And I think that's one way, just because that symbiote knows everything about Spider-Man and it's so personal. But like, Green Goblin killed Gwen Stacy.
Oh, yeah.
Well, sort of. He
made
Spider-Man kill. Yeah, he facilitated it. And
he
then,
made it happen.
And just like the... kind of tug of war between Peter Parker and Norman Osborn, and Harry was involved as his best friend. It's pretty interesting.
And he was early on too. Remember that one time
where he
found out Peter Parker was Spider-Man, and so he hunted down Peter Parker.
Mm-hmm.
This is like way early on, because Peter had that slick back hair and like really nice dress clothes, and he had his Spider-Man suit underneath his clothes, and Green Goblin just like caught him out of nowhere and like, you know, threw these like all these pumpkin bombs at him and all these bat knives, and he just like wrapped him up in a rope and just drug him around the air.
Didn't it disorient him or somehow, like give him a concussion or something? We got hit by all those and then he grabbed him because he was kind of unconscious.
Yeah, maybe the explosions.
I thought
he does look like
just out in the open. Don't give a fuck if he's just Peter Parker. He's just gonna come out and grab him. I don't think he's ever dealt with anything like that before.
Yeah, and he's like, Green Goblin's been there since the beginning.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
he was
okay, just not gonna
flying around on his broomstick since day
and
one.
And the other interesting thing about him is he's got a lot of goblin stashes all over, like, New York.
That's
just
cool.
Spread out everywhere. That has a glider, all his gear, costume. They're just in these secret places. So
whenever he loses it.
Yeah, that's how...
he needs it close by.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. People have found those, and they've modified them. That's where that one with the fiery sword came from.
Oh,
he stumbled upon one.
That was a Hobgoblin.
Yeah,
the newest Hobgoblin.
Hobgoblin, I think he had stashes too, but it was main... They all stole from Norman Osborn a lot.
Yeah.
Like, I need a glider.
He's
all they were all
in
jail at different times.
Yeah.
I need a glider. Oh! There's a secret stash over there.
I got two around the corner.
I think
but I was like, I like that.
Yeah.
That was very...
That is cool. Stashes around the city.
He's always prepared.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He was leading the Dark Avengers and...
Yeah, he has like the coolest weapons too. The pumpkin bomb is so cool. It's pretty iconic.
Awesome. It is.
It is. It's really awesome.
And it looks really nice. It's all like smoking. There's a trail of smoke. It always has like a pouch full of endless ones.
Oh yeah. Never ending bag of Bumpkin Bomb.
Just throws it in a bag.
So cool. I've always loved those. Really cool aesthetic.
Yeah, it is. And it goes well with him, Pumpkin.
It does, perfect.
Mm-hmm. They concuss you.
He is a really good character.
Man, we're talking about him, I really want to read some.
Yeah, dude.
Read some Norman Osborn Goblin
comics.
Yeah, there are some good ones. I remember there was one where he led the Sinister Six. That's when Scorpion got the symbiote, and Norman was pissed at him, like, "Are you planning for this?"
Meticulous plan. And
yeah, he didn't plan. He planned for him to have this Scorpion suit that Norman Osborn developed.
Shit.
Dude, that was awesome. That was Marvel Knights Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Oscorpion. Yeah.
New Ways to Die?
No, this was before that. Yeah. Yeah, love this Scorpion. Is like Black Cat.
Scorpion's cool. Let's talk about Scorpion next. I think that's enough. We should do a character special on Green Goblin, though.
For sure.
I'm really stoked about it.
He's good, yeah. That's a...
Clearly there's enough there to
do an episode about Spider-Man is to Goblin as the Batman is to Joker.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Do some research.
Mm-hmm.
Get real philosophical about it.
Yeah, you get some comparative...
Just compare shit. Batman and Spider-Man. I'm telling you, dude, there are a lot of similarities between those two.
Compare and contrast.
Yeah, there's differences, but there's similarities. It's weird. Mm-hmm. Like, I think if you really think about it, they've got a lot.
Enough of the Goblin. Let's talk about Scorpion.
All right, let's talk about Scorpion.
Scorpion's always been a favorite of mine.
Mine too. I've always liked Scorpion.
I'm not a fan of Matt Gargan.
Matt Gargan's pretty dumb.
I always just like the way he looked. That tail was cool.
Yeah.
Like whether it had a laser or like a stabbing point.
Or like shoot acid out of it sometimes.
Yeah, I think it was fucking cool. And it's green. I love green. So.
He has a thing on his back. He has the claws.
Yeah.
And he's like super strong too.
I always liked Scorpion.
He had those enhancements.
Yeah.
He was always one of my favorites.
That suit always gave him enhancements, I think.
I think his origin... I think so many of Spider-Man's villains' origin stories are just some jabroni they got off the streets that they just tested this...
got trapped in a suit, just like Rhino.
Yeah, they got trapped in a suit. They can't get it off, and so they just rob banks.
They got to rob banks so they can raise enough money to get the super move.
Oscorp put me in the suit, and they can't get me out.
That's usually what happens.
So I gotta get enough money to get them to get me out of it.
That's why, like, they're kind of tragic, because they're not really bad people. They're just in this horrible circumstance.
Yeah, poor Rhino's glued to the interior of the fucking Rhino suit.
Can't get it off.
Oh my god, I've still been growing hair. It is so itchy.
It hurts. I have so many ingrown hairs, you have no idea.
My hair hurts. I live a life of pain.
This horn gets in the way of everything.
I have a hard exterior, but only pain on the inside.
I'm a creamy, it's creamy on the inside.
Yeah,
it's exterior.
Wet.
He's like, okay, anyway, we're talking about Scorpion.
We'll get to Rhino.
We'll get to Rhino.
Scorpion kind of looked stupid when he first showed up.
Every one of them
did.
He had like a tail that was just like round and looked like a dildo.
It looked like they did that in the cartoon too.
Yeah.
It looked okay in the cartoon sometimes, but just that rounded end.
Itself when it wasn't armed or whatever.
I didn't like that.
Yeah,
I
like
that
the little
really...
kind of bayonet on it.
It looked really...
Who wore it best, Scorpion or Scorponok?
Scorponok was a lot cooler.
I thought Scorponok was a lot cooler.
I had that toy.
Man,
it
was
my
badass.
Favorite one, dude. I love that. And he was... Like, he'd fuck people up with those missiles.
Yeah, and his claws, for sure.
Yeah.
He was cool.
Just, like, knock his arm back and
reshot recoil's
him.
A little crazy.
Yeah, he was really cool.
Yeah, that bee that he shot out.
Yeah, man, that bee.
That was cool. Man, those first wave Beast Wars were the fucking
those
shit.
Were really cool, dude. I love that Scorpion.
That Scorpion was really cool. I remember when you guys had that as a kid. You both had it. I was like, yeah, that's really cool.
But you had the ant. Inferno.
Oh, yeah,
Inferno. That guy was
cool.
That guy was really cool, dude.
Man, I had Polar Claw.
Yeah.
Which one never appeared in the show.
had Rhinox.
Yeah, Rhinox.
Rhinox.
Rhinox, cool.
See, yeah, that was a really cool.
It seems like he should have been bigger.
You had Rat Pack, too, or Rat Trap.
I had Rat Trap.
You had the metallic Rat Trap.
Was that you?
Okay.
And I love that one, too, dude.
They
that
were all really good.
Awesome.
You had the Cheetor?
I had the Cheetor.
You had the metallic one and the regular one, the animal one?
Right? No, I didn't have the regular
one. I had the metallic.
I had the metallic one
as well.
Yeah,
you both had that too, yeah.
That was cool, dude. I love that one.
God, That was a good one. Awesome. And the Metallic Optimus.
Yeah, we both had the Metallic Optimus.
He had that skateboard, like his shins
turned into like a skateboard. Dude. That was a good one.
They were all really pretty good.
Like, see, he was the right size.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but Rhinox should have been bigger.
Way bigger. Like, he should have been at least the size of Megatron or Optimus Primal.
Yeah. Sure. He should have been a deluxe.
Yeah, he should have been a deluxe. Because so many. And when the first wave came through, Optimus was a bat and Megatron was an alligator. And then they switched it up right before the fucking show came out. Because I remember the toy wave came out and the first Optimus Prime and Megatron thing you get your hands on was a bat, a gray and blue bat, and a green alligator.
Oh.
And he was purple, was the alternate color. But then when the show came out, it was a ape and a T-Rex. And then eventually those toys came out as well.
I kind of like those better.
Way better.
Yeah, a T-Rex?
Bat?
A T-Rex?
Yeah.
We have a T-Rex.
And his arm was a T-Rex head that would shoot that beam out.
That giant beam. Cool.
It was awesome. Yeah, and his other arm was the tail.
Yeah.
To do the arm.
Just like Dinozord. Arm.
Yeah.
He was a badass.
He had the spinning one.
He was like the Wolverine of the Transformers universe.
He bailed on the Decepticons and joined the...
Tell tried that to, trap, I gave him a convertible.
Challenge. He tried to challenge
Optimus Primal.
Optimus Primal, yeah.
Didn't he challenge Megatron first, and Megatron kicked him out?
Yeah, then he went over and tried to beat up. He lost there too.
Yeah, he just joined.
But they didn't kick him out for it.
He had to save him. Yeah, but man, that guy was my favorite. He died.
Yeah, he did. He was a hero.
Oh yeah,
he's a true hero.
Dude, he is Vegeta.
Yeah,
he is. Who he reminds me of is Vegeta. Because he's so proud. And he thinks he's the strongest there is. And nobody can face him. Yeah. He gets his ass kicked. And then he develops. He's probably the only character in that whole series that developed. Just like Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah, really. Yeah.
Definitely.
That character, just for some reason. I always liked that character.
I agree for sure. He was the only character that had any development at all.
He's like by far the most interesting.
He's the only dynamic character in the whole fucking
thing. And he's badass.
Well, no, that
too.
And the arachnid, the female arachnid. What was her name? She was like yellow and black.
Yeah. Widow? Was it the Widow?
Was that it?
Black Widow, maybe?
She became a Maximal.
Yeah, she switched sides too.
Yeah. She betrayed that Tarantulus.
Yeah. He was like performing experiments on her and shit.
Yeah.
Did he make her?
I think he made her.
I kind of think so too. She turned against her creator.
She did. Really? Wow, we really went off.
We went off track a little.
Beast Wars going
out of nowhere. And then Beast Wars. Beast Wars. But none of them had treads on their feet. So
that's not true. I bet you.
Name one. Name one with treads.
What was
John Namath? Name one with treads. None of them had treads. Scorpion's cool though.
Fucking Rat Trap had fucking wheels on it. Come on.
Okay, yeah, you did. That's true.
Yes.
And you know you love those wheels, dude. Those wheels were awesome.
They were cool, man, weren't they?
Well, wheels are better than tracks. Wheels are better than tracks.
What? They had tread-like texture.
And a wheel shape.
So it's a very,
two worlds come together to make something amazing. Okay? We're talking about a very specific kind of wheel.
Drew has a certain kind of taste.
But technically they are treads. The wheels had the treads.
Well, all wheels have treads, though.
Well, not these kind of treads. Not like tank treads, like where it's,
Let's go back to Scorpion. I'm getting too pissed off in this conversation.
I'm getting furious.
I keep bringing it up. I'm going to convince you that fucking Triceratops tread wheel fucking cool.
Yeah. We'll see. It makes sense, maybe, man. It makes sense.
It's got to be below the ground so it can...
sense. How does it make sense?
It's because it's got to be below the ground.
Every other Zord... You know it's a Triceratops because of the head.
Every other Zord
has... You know it's a Triceratops.
All the other ones except for the pterodactyl. Why does that have tank treads?
Because...
Riddle me that.
It rams things. And it can just ram them faster with wheels. Everyone knows that.
What about cheetahs? Or no, saber-tooth tiger? No, they leap.
They had wheels too, though.
No, it didn't.
Yes, it did. On its back hip. Its back hip, those wheels would come in and those wheels would start.
Yeah, they had wheels.
It even had wheels on the back of its legs, actually.
It had wheels. Not treads.
Okay.
You're right.
Hey, here we go.
Look at this. It's got, he has treads, which are brutals.
I mean,
he's
got these legs. I can see the legs.
Look, Drew, just
that's
just
what it was. That's not how it was, really?
God. Yes.
Yeah, that was it. Exactly what it was. Did you see it?
I don't know.
No.
Right. You just trust me. He knows.
I've seen it. I know.
Yeah, Power Rangers Zord.
Yeah.
Triceratops? Man, I
look,
I'll
find
legs.
Another picture. Look at this.
Yeah, I'll find another one. That's
cool as shit.
I cool. see legs. I see legs.
They're
yeah,
hips.
They are
they're
legs.
Like, they're more like,
yeah,
more
they
like
are.
Spinders,
they're there,
really.
But they're just, you legs. Know, for aesthetic purposes.
They're not functional.
Bad
I don't
spot.
Get it. I don't get it.
Oh, my God. It's so good. It's
stupid.
See, the but the Sabertooth probably has the same thing.
Sabertooth has wheels, Donovan.
It had the exact.
Look it up.
I will. You think I won't?
It does have wheels.
Does have wheels.
You think I won't, dude? I've got a lot of data left.
Yeah. Anyway, Scorpion's pretty cool.
Scorpion's badass. Not as cool as Scorponok, but still pretty
still
cool.
Still up there. That's pretty much it. There's
oh,
not
it
really
did
much
wheels.
To him. Yeah, I told it to Donnie. I know everything.
Only had two
John
wheels.
Just told me what it was. I've known that all along. My whole life. Never questioned.
But it makes more sense for the Sabertooth.
Yeah.
Triceratops, you really want to see the
Triceratops.
Triceratops
doesn't have to run that
They
fast.
Gotta move quick, dude. They gotta form up.
Yeah.
Form the Megazord. They gotta come out of the volcanoes.
Form up, and then they gotta rise up, like, defying
they
gravity.
They transform. Make these ridiculous impossible
maybe
moves.
If, yeah. Maybe if he could switch out the feet, the legs for wheels, I'd take it.
But I don't see the point of that. What's the point?
What would it look like?
Why
it would look
point?
Like a pig
why
trying
does,
to run.
Why does the saber-toothed tiger have
because saber-toothed tiger is
slender.
It's graceful.
Yeah.
It's meant to run.
Exactly.
Triceratops is don't run.
They don't run like
have
that. They stay put
and
they hit you with their head.
You guys, when did the Triceratops ever hit anything?
When he shot his fucking horns out of his head and they had chains on him and they'd wrap around the enemy? What?
That's true.
Yeah, well, why does he need true. To why does he need to race towards something to do that if he shoots them out of his head?
He's just trying to get to wherever the Power Rangers are quick.
Yeah, as fast
okay.
as
well,
as
maybe
that's
okay, well,
thinking.
Maybe
exactly.
he could have
he
some...
He treads for
all
the Blue Ranger hate. I'm fucking tired of it.
It's just...
I'm
I
tired of
it.
Is
I don't cool. hate Billy.
Blue Lives Matter.
I don't hate Billy, okay?
Don't hate Billy.
Don't hate Billy.
Billy's great.
He's
the brains.
Cool.
He's
the brains
of the
whole
operation.
Remember one time he got a bee and then they had to fight a bee? That was some...
That's some fucked up shit.
Right. That's, yeah, it was psychological for Billy. He was,
that
he
is,
was, he was just psyching himself out.
Man, a bee is devastating to him.
Mm. He's an A student.
Doc Ock.
Boy. This guy. I, this is another
not
one...
my favorite.
...that I think could almost be... a nemesis too.
Really?
Oh yeah, dude. Don't he's early on and he hates fucking Spider-Man because he can never beat him. That's the only reason he hates him. And he's smarter than Peter Parker, I think.
Yeah.
And then
he makes a better Spider-Man than Peter Parker.
He did. He kind of
yeah,
did.
Yeah, he's a supreme superior Spider-Man.
The superior
Spider-Man. Well, he didn't want to be good. Why was he bad in the first place? Was
dude,
he trying to
shitty
was
childhood?
Was
dude.
He robbing banks to try and
Get out of his fucking arms.
He
was,
wasn't
he?
I gotta just rob a couple banks.
Yeah.
And then I can finally get these goddamn
no,
arms.
Dude,
yeah,
it's Robin Banks.
It's Mr. Freeze syndrome.
To fund his research. Okay. But like he,
you know, and that guy could really just, what is he researching for when he has these amazing arms that he built?
Dude,
really?
Ways
or
to
just
beat
sell
Spider-Man.
That, you know?
Ways to beat Spider-Man.
Oh, he's researching right. ways to beat Spider-Man?
Well, he's trying, always trying to come up with new ways. It's all he's doing because he hates the fact plotting. That he's never won against Spider-Man.
Man.
And that's how he got into Spider-Man's brain in the first place.
Oh,
like, he led
research.
A new Sinister Six that was just messing everything up all over the world. They're actually being successful.
He was
and,
the original leader
oh,
of the Sinister
shit.
Six.
He was, yeah.
That's
he
cool.
formed them.
I always kind of like
he formed them because he knew
yeah,
that
he's pretty cool. Yeah.
His
really,
arms
yeah.
Cute.
Yeah, I really like I think that's a cool idea, his arms. But he only has oh no, he does have eight limbs.
Well, he's got
feet and hands.
Two arms.
A total of four robo arms, right?
Yeah.
I
think he's yeah, I really like him. I think he's a cool villain.
I think he is. He tried to marry Aunt May.
Yeah. He's always kind of on the fringe.
He is.
He's not really so bad. He's just really smart, and he had a bad childhood, and he's
yeah,
fucked
really
up
bad
from
childhood,
that.
Yeah. He's a guy. I think he's pretty good.
He's better than Penguin.
On Batman's
yeah,
side,
yeah,
that
I always
kind of
put them in the same boat, but
yeah.
I like him more.
Yeah.
I can see that.
I think at least he kind of has... He's interesting.
Yeah.
In a way.
Those robot arms are fucking cool.
He does look really cool sometimes.
What do you like better? Do you like the lab coat, Doc Ock? Or do you like the animated series with the armor, the yellow
I like the lab coat.
Lab coat, for sure.
Yeah, I like the lab coat better.
I think he was really good in Spider-Man 2.
Yeah.
He did a really great job.
That was
he
really good. When
cool
they're fighting
too.
On top of that building, it's
it was
coin
yeah.
sacks
like he looked awesome. Lethal. He looked frightening. Like
yeah,
I was like, that's badass. That's the most badass version of Dr. Octopus I've ever seen.
Yeah. Yeah.
He was really good. He did have that. He went like a trench coat.
Yeah.
Instead, but that worked.
Mm-hmm.
It
looked
worked
good.
For him. That was. He was probably like one of the best parts of that movie.
For sure.
Kraven the Hunter.
Kraven.
Oh,
I don't
dude.
Get his goddamn costume. It makes me mad.
His leopard pants?
I like his costume.
Pants
I think it makes sense.
He's
wearing
leopard.
I love
his trophy.
Leopard
capris.
He's wearing
his
I
trophy.
I love the leopard capris.
You don't like the tiger face?
I
the
love
lion
the
face
fur.
On his vest.
The lion
I love the fur. I
the
do not understand.
Call
his
mane?
His mane.
Yeah,
the split lion face. Vest. I don't get it.
Dude,
what
you don't understand, bro, okay? He can shoot lasers out of the lion's eyes. And they just happen
so
to be lined up with
the nipples.
That's
ridiculous.
But, like, yeah.
He doesn't get out much. He spent most of his time in
Africa.
Being
in
a fucking poacher.
Hunting the most dangerous game.
They find Spider-Man with a symbiote.
And he, so
no, what? He didn't have the symbiote.
Just regular Spider-Man.
He's a
yeah,
really
but he had the he had the
too.
Black costume. He had a black costume because he didn't want people to think he lost it.
Yeah.
Anything had changed.
Yeah, oh, yeah, no, he wore the black costume.
Yeah.
Wait, but Kraven showed up long before that. He was in the first Sinister Six too, wasn't he?
Yeah, I think they fought when... Yeah, they fought when he was like regular Spider-Man, but their biggest one, like the Kraven... what is that called? The Kraven's
Last Hunt. Yeah.
That one was when Spider-Man was just in a cloth black costume.
Yeah. And he made one too for himself.
Yeah, he did.
To you have to dress
Spider-Man.
Dress like your enemy. You must become your enemy.
That's why he's wearing that vest, John.
I never liked him. I thought he was dumb.
Dude, really? Oh, I always. Dude, like before you go hunting and go over this like pot and just inhale all this crazy gas.
That's cool.
And go out on it, heighten all his senses.
Then he'd get into like the worst outfit imaginable.
Well,
with all the gas, it looked cool.
It looked cool.
He's really fucked up.
He's like checking
just
out his
badass.
Checking out his ass in the capris.
In the capris.
Okay.
I gotta do more calf lifts. I gotta do more hummingbirds. Start to lose it.
Was he always just trying to kill Spider-Man because he was like the
his greatest
kill.
Challenge.
He's like the Wile E. Coyote.
He's like
Spider-Man. Spider-Man
always gets away just like... That's what he does with all of these people.
Yeah.
Every single one. Venom.
That's true.
Doc Ock, Green Goblin. They're all pissed at him because they can't.
Oh, yeah. I wrote down Punisher, too.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Shut up.
I always thought that Kraven and Punisher kind of had similar motivations.
But Kraven doesn't give a shit. But Punisher.
Raven's all about the hunt. He's like the predator.
Like he has morals or principles. Principles
is not in here. It's cool. But yeah, I see the sentiment for sure.
They're hunters, John.
Yeah, they're not
they're after the prey.
They are not in the same league.
You got
Kraven the hunter and the
Yana
predator species.
They're both on the same level.
They are not. Even playing the same game.
Well, if they got in a fight, I don't know.
I think it'd be fun to watch. I don't know.
Like, Predator would whoop his ass so fast.
It would die in like 5 minutes.
He'd have a hole blown through his chest.
He'd see some glowing blood on the ground. And as he's like smelling it, Predator would just blast
Zonk.
His face.
Zonk.
Throw a spear straight through.
Yeah.
Him.
Yeah.
Straight into a tree.
Like, gets the arm, too. Oh, man, that's funny. You should... Poor listeners can't see the incredible...
We could animate it or something.
Yeah,
that'd be a good thing to animate.
Mm-hmm. I have to record it and rotoscope it.
Rotoscope.
Yeah, Kraven wouldn't stand a chance. I'm starting out. Right. Kraven wouldn't stand a chance.
I
think Kraven's cool, though. I kind of like him.
Yeah.
I like him.
Yeah.
I think he's interesting. I like him in a funny way. He kind of cracks me up.
There was a really good Venture Brothers character that was a mock of Craven, and it was he was really funny.
I like that idea of the hunter who just he does he is he like super rich?
He has to be.
Oh yeah,
I mean, he's gotta be.
He's a puncher, man.
Has afford this kind of straight lifestyle. Has he been doing this since he was a kid? Probably. He knows nothing but hunting.
I think he was born into money.
Yeah.
Like, I think he's just a rich kid.
I like to go into his background. See, I'm reading about him now too.
I don't think the mic will pick that up.
No problem.
It didn't. It didn't hit the decibel level.
Yeah.
I'm wired of it.
Noise reduction enhancer. Yeah, that's
a I like Craven.
I think it's cool.
Like, Craven's Last Hunt was a great fucking story.
That's when he died, right?
Yeah.
He shot himself.
Sounds about right.
That's when he buried Spider-Man alive.
Yeah. And then shot himself.
Yeah.
Why was he just like, well, that was my biggest challenge I'll ever face.
Wait, whoa. No. I think you're mixing this up. That's from the newer one. With his daughter.
You're mixing it up, Drew.
No, I have the issue where he died. On the cover, it's a weird cover.
When he first died?
When he killed himself. Because on the cover, it shows him, like, in the foreground with a rifle, and he's looking for Spider-Man. And in the background is this, like, wall full of heads of animals he's killed, and Spider-Man's crawling on the heads in his black costume. Craven's Last Hunt, I think it's the last issue.
Maybe.
Mm. He just
sounds pretty right about it.
I have it. So we may go back and check it out.
That's pretty serious detail about that.
Yeah. That is a lot of detail. I thought the detail is convincing.
I thought the cover was cool. That's the only reason I bought it, really. And I was like, I was a kid when I bought it. So, when Craven dies, I wonder what happens. It's got to be insanely climactic.
Yeah.
And I'm like reading it.
And it's going to be in a bathtub and he has a rifle and he just shoots himself.
Dude, fuck? It's just dark.
Spider-Man just wall crawls into that. Ooh.
Cause everybody hurts sometimes.
Oh, man. Hydro-Man. That's one of my
personal Hydro-Man.
Hydro-Man.
God, we can't even talk about Sandman. We gotta talk about Hydro-Man.
I kind of have them in the same sort of deal.
They're kind of similar.
I remember Hydro-Man in the cartoon was really good.
Remember the action figures.
This is just
figures.
A regular burglar. That's all he did.
Yeah, they're all burglars. Yeah. Most of them were.
Did
burglars.
He have a striped shirt too?
He had just a black
shirt.
No, he
had like black. Yeah, solid he had black. Like jeans and a black shirt.
And so he was like Sandman, but he would turn into water instead.
Yeah,
yeah.
Instead, yeah.
That's the extent of it.
Spider-Man he always would throw semen at him.
Yeah.
Easy.
Easy.
Done. But and then he invented this special webbing that would stop him and Sandman. It wasn't the same kind, but just different kinds. They would just shoot at him, and then they're... Because I remember, like, it was a later issue. It was Hydro-Man comes out. Oh, Spider-Man, I'm back! And Spider-Man just shoots this thing at him, and he's done. It's like, you don't think I'm prepared? Bro, I'm a scientist, okay?
And I like that. Another like, similarity.
That's what you, yeah, that's out. What I always liked, because he didn't do that all the time, but sometimes he'd be... thinking about that stuff. Mm-hmm. And I always liked it when that happened. Because you think later on in the career, like, Hydro-Man just wouldn't be able to...
Yeah.
He'd think of something for that.
It's pretty easy.
Yeah.
If it's just water, there's things you could do about that. Iceman always took care of Hydro-Man pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Don't...
Don't stand a chance.
Doesn't, like, Sandman and, like, Hydro-Man, don't they get in a fight once and one of them just, like, mops the floor with the other?
I imagine Sandman would be the one that
I
won.
Think so.
Maybe...
I thought Hydro-Man. Water might win.
He might wash away the sand.
Yeah, because water is more powerful. Yeah, it erodes like the Great Cage.
Yeah.
All right, Hydro-Man. Hydro-Man's fucking cool. I like him.
He always. You guys remember Snake from Simpsons?
Yeah.
His alter ego, or him, his personal, like what he actually looked like when he was like in his human form, always reminded me of Snake from.
Oh.
Simpsons.
Oh yeah.
Premium. Dude, that hair.
Premium.
H2O, bro!
Yeah.
liquid water, man!
Alright, well, we gotta start wrapping this up. Shocker. We gotta talk about
Shocker. Our
podcast favorite.
Yeah,
Shocker.
Number,
Shocker's always one. So boy. Awesome.
Shocker.
I don't want it either, really.
He's just, so bizarre.
He is very... He's a one of... Yeah, he is a very bizarre villain.
Another guy who's just like a straight-up bank robber.
That's
he doesn't
all
know
he
what
does.
Else to do.
The carpeted like, criminal.
He just wears that quilt.
The quilted crook.
Just blast shocking people.
Are they sonic waves? Is that electricity? I don't care. It looks so cool.
I think it's concussive. I think it's concussive.
I think it is too.
Which is just weird, like a sonic concussive, like...
Yeah, the name Shocker does not mean misleading. Anything about it. But I think it's shocking. He's just shocking.
Like, it's shock, yeah.
It's, yeah, it's
he's
like...
providing
it's
a shock
like,
to the
yeah,
electric. Like shell shock.
It's just, mm-hmm. yeah.
Yeah.
Like, damn, I was not expecting
those
that.
Cool bracers on his arms that...
Yeah.
Would admit it. He kind of had Wolverine's color scheme a little bit,
yeah.
which is just going to appeal to me in really any way.
His alter ego is Herman Schultz.
Yeah,
no, Herman.
Herminator.
Check him out. He's got Super Runaway.
He's such a good character in the cartoon series, too.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Where Shocker! He's chased down by the symbiote Spider-Man.
Spider-Man just crushes his gauntlets.
Yeah. Yeah.
No! He's done what he's doing.
He's done. He's done.
That's it.
I'm sure paying all those. Those are on loan from Oscorp.
That guy totally has to be in the Sinister Six. He needs some friends.
He's been in there, yeah.
Love Shocker.
Yeah.
He's one of my favorites of all time.
I love him, too. Yeah, the design, the character is funny.
Just
he's
cool.
Awesome. Mysterio.
You know,
not
Mysterio, that's
not
an interesting. You're on the fence with that.
What is he trying to? Is he Robin Banks too? Is he?
He's a special effects master who, like, is like the master of illusion and shit. So, yeah, he, like, robs banks.
He's like a magician.
Like that, yeah.
He is.
And he can
yeah.
literally trick you into seeing shit you don't see because he's so good at special effects.
Yeah.
I was like that.
Yeah.
But he always looks so fucking stupid.
You like the fishbowl?
No, well, don't get me wrong.
I don't know. Yeah,
I kind of like the fishbowl if it was more like Mr. Freeze, where you're like, maybe if there's a fog in it and you say you have like a silhouetted head inside, but I didn't just like the globe.
It was just that.
Like a fish.
Sometimes it was just gas.
Yeah.
Green gas. But I think like the actual, because he'd always have those images of himself out there.
Yeah.
And those would be full of gas.
I like
gas,
Mysterio.
But he is kind of like a, you know, you like him, but, you know, whatever.
He's never very exciting.
No. I remember in the cartoon when the Sinister Six got together, he had this giant crate of something, and Rhino bashed into it. They're like holograms.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, the whole warehouse turns into a jungle.
Yeah. That's cool.
It's like, that's all he does. He's so good at that
I think
stuff.
He could be done really well.
Yeah,
I think so too.
It's just maybe I just haven't seen him kind of done that well. I think if they do it in the new Marvel movies, like when Disney gets a hold of them, I think they could.
Oh,
make
I think
they'd
so do
it.
I
really
that
hope
seems
they
like
do
right
this
for the pick
for sure.
Like,
right,
yeah,
right
yeah.
up their alley.
Great,
yeah.
A great explanation.
Mm-hmm. Special
I mean,
effects master. That's
yeah.
all you got.
I mean, that's cool. I like that illusion.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's
yeah.
it's a different approach.
Just
I've always liked his design. Like I like his.
I like Tom McFarlane did a great job.
Yeah, I didn't like the big metal like eye pieces that held his cape on.
Oh,
maybe
yeah.
if he didn't have that, I'd have been more into it. But I still like him as a character for sure.
He's
pretty original.
Yeah, definitely.
He is. Yeah,
he's a better version of
Scarecrow.
Like yeah. Scarecrow is like the easy way out in a character, making a character. Mysterio is a little bit more creative, I think.
He's really different.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
He's
yeah,
really
never thought
different.
About that.
Kind of similar, just like changing the environment and themselves around you. By
messing,
yeah.
with
your
messing with your mind.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
he's part of the Sinister Six, too, wasn't he?
Yeah, at one point.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love Mysterio.
Another... Okay, we gotta just you do a couple more. How about this, Vulture? Did you have any on your list, John, you want to go over?
I think... no, it's not over there. We covered...
We covered
the ones
I wanted
Vulture?
To talk about.
Like, what else do you
yeah, yeah, Vulture.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We are talking about Vulture.
I'll talk about it.
We got two more.
Like,
two more and you
there's others.
Vulture.
We got Rhino. Man, we've got fucking. I mean, there's others.
I'm
sorry,
dude.
I was
sorry.
Maybe
you're
a
Vulture fan.
I
love
Vulture.
He's my favorite villain. Chameleon.
I've been looking forward to this all night.
Jackal.
He's in all caps.
Yes, yes, sorry to laugh.
He's in all caps.
Yeah, sorry about that, dude.
I mean,
yeah,
I'm
talking about Vulture.
I'm just curious. I'm just asking a question.
Like
I can't ask
Vulture's
questions.
Fucking tight.
That's what I'm talking about. Vulture's so dope, bro. Vulture, I just want to talk about one thing with him. Like, why did he turn younger at one point?
Because, dude, that's his whole thing.
He absorbs
wants to try and get young. He doesn't want to be old. He's trying to absorb people's life force.
Yeah.
He was light because he teamed up with the Jackal, who invented
mm-hmm.
Peter Parker's robot parents.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that was part of the deal. And he gave him these like gauntlets, and he had that orange hair kind of. He's dressed as a young vulture. Yeah, that's all. This is whole thing.
I like that. I like that ability.
It's a cool ability. Was it like a Shang Tsung
defibrillator that he had that stole life, or did he just grab people?
I think he just grabbed people and suck it out of them.
Because I think like that's cool.
I think he was facing a life sentence in jail.
Fine then, I will live forever.
I can't remember.
I will be.
And that's what he was.
I will outlive your law.
And he's like an old man. And he looks like a dirty old dude.
He's a Patrick Stewart in a vulture costume
with the vulture puffy thing around his neck.
Why even
throw that in?
I never liked that look.
It was really weird. He really embraced that look.
I think he's gonna look better in the new movie though.
Yeah. I cannot wait to see Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton, the Batman in the house.
I think he'll look like the one, the young one. Like you're talking about, because he had that metal suit.
Yeah, the mechanized. I'll take a mechanized vulture
suit. That's cool.
Suit.
That
looks really much.
But
better.
He was a pretty.
Get him out of that skin tight old man suit.
Yeah, the reeds,
the feathers.
Please.
Okay, enough about vulture. I got my.
Get him out of here.
Fly away, sheep vulture.
He's all right.
Chameleon.
Chameleon. Chameleon is a great character. That guy is crazy.
I love shapeshifters.
Yeah, he's crazier than people think. Like. He's
really?
Always involved.
I don't think I've ever read comics with
him. And the Jackal are always teamed up. He was involved in Peter Parker's parents, too.
He disguises himself as him.
He just
has disguises. That's his only thing.
I know, man, but he's playing all these sides.
He could do so much
more with it. I liked it better when he could turn into people. I don't really like how he could disguise himself. Like, he has to have masks and stuff.
He just pulls the mask off.
Yeah, because he's always wearing like, silver mask or whatever. But then he wears masks over that mask.
He's cool like in a crime boss kind of way, I guess. I just remember in the Spider-Man animated series, he was all like huge and he had that crazy armored outfit. I guess everybody had armored outfits.
Oh, yeah.
Doc Ock.
It was in the 90s.
He had that little
belt
he pressed and he turned into...
Yeah.
But I guess that's cooler whenever... Jeez, are you bored, Donovan? Am I
boring
you?
Boring me with your vulture.
Bored. She's a rhino!
It's a great character, Donovan.
What? Alright. No, goddamn.
No, I don't know. I like Chameleon. I think he's cool. He's always teamed up with the Jackal. Those two always work together. Jackal is, like, a really bad enemy because he's just super smart. I don't really know all about him, but he's just always involved in these crazy grand schemes.
I want to read
Spider-Man. He's just playing Spider-Man.
That's
like,
cool, yeah.
Like a flute, you know, manipulating stuff in the back room.
That's the one character I need to read more of.
I know, me too. He always pops up, and I'm like, oh, there he is again, but I don't really know what he's about.
Alright, okay. It's time to top off this podcast with the last guy. Let's talk about Rhino.
Rhino.
Yeah.
What's his name?
I love Rhino.
His name is Rhino.
Ivan? Is it Ivan? No, it's not Ivan.
Ivan Bashu.
Is he Russian?
Ivan Bashu.
I just got it. I like that. That's good.
I'm 60 years old and I saved all of my birthday cakes. Why? So I can crush them.
What?
Oh my god.
Is that sweepstakes to go ride in a tank with Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Yeah, come ride with me in my tank. Come on, let's go.
When you said it, I didn't remember that. And I'm like, why did Arnold would say that? And then, no, he actually did.
He did.
Cakes.
Why?
He has all these different cakes.
Crush them. I'll punish people who try to cross into my party. Y'all, you get away from my cake. That's my cake.
My cake. Crush it.
It's my cake.
What is this from? What is this?
It was a sweepstakes to
ride in the tank with him, I think. And he would just run over shit with his tank. That's all it was.
Yeah.
Just a show where he'd just run over
some
shit
charity.
With his tank.
I have no idea.
Come with me. With my tank. We'll go on my tank. Come on.
Was this like a real thing? Or
yeah.
Like
oh,
it's
oh we'll watch it after this. I'll show it to you.
Oh,
it's
okay.
Real deal.
He has a tank.
He it was the... Yeah. Go, Dunny.
Drove.
Go.
We used the... Austrian Army!
He was in the Austrian Army?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he actually skipped out. He went AWOL to go do one of his Mr. Olympian shows or championships or whatever, and he won. By the time he got back, they realized he had, like, escaped, but they didn't punish him because he got first place.
So. I gotta read that guy's biography.
Dude, he's fucking good.
Yeah, fucking I think it'd be awesome. I think it'd be super inspirational.
Dude, that man is an inspiration.
I mean, it's insane. Because Bill Burr really puts it well.
Yeah.
Great man. He's a great man.
Goes to a country where he can't speak the language and dominates. And marries
everything. Governor. Seriously. Gets famous for lifting weights.
This podcast definitely has deep love for Arnold Schwarzenegger, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I do. Man.
Fuck yeah, yeah, dude. Definitely. That guy is it's insane.
He's a mentor.
I mean, he just can't stop killing
it.
He's just killing it. Killing it. Having the best life
ever. Always.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah. he's a true inspiration.
He is, man.
Man, I wish he played Rhino.
Oh.
Rhino.
I'm the Rhino. Rhino. With the Genju spanner, man. You're a cow.
I'm getting ready to charge.
I hope you're not hiding in front of
the electrical devices.
Not in front of a box.
I could potentially get my horn stuck into.
Circuit breaker?
Circuit breaker.
Yeah.
Don't stand in front of circuit breaker, Spider-Man.
God, I'm really terrible at that.
It was close. It was
Swedish. Wow, Spider-Man, Schwarzenegger.
That was straight up German.
It is German.
If I just see my horn, Spider-Man,
I'm Mr. Universe.
It's Transylvanian.
I'm just mixing them all up.
Oi! Right, I'm Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Australian, for sure.
Right. I'll be back.
I'll be back, mate.
That was better.
You didn't.
Yeah, that was better.
Know why you cry? I know why you cry, but some I can't do.
Some I can never do.
Sorry,
I can never do.
Rhino's alter ego is Alexei Sistevich.
I always liked his name, Alexei's.
Sistevich.
Yeah. Sistevich.
Robin Banks trying to get that costume off.
He's got a daughter. He's trying to get money for his
Isn't that Sandman?
Yeah, Sandman too. They both have daughters.
He kind of reformed once. He's walking around in like human clothes over his rhino suit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Poor guy. He's goddamn stuck in there forever.
Yeah, it sucks, man. You know, Power Man really was the only one that got... really came out on top with those like experiments in jail.
Yeah,
and in the rhino suit.
I thought it was a way out for like Power way to reduce his sentence.
Oh, he's called Power Man.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, that's what his comic is called.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, they that's did, why they kept mentioning it, and like Pops called him Power Man.
Holy shit!
Show. Yeah, when he had that tiara and the yellow.
I looked over to him. I'm like, does that mean something? But I didn't remember that at all. Power Man.
It was like his very first comic.
That's why he was in Heroes for Hire, I think.
That's fucking sick.
He didn't have his, like, isn't that right? Because it didn't, in that way.
I think that's his very first, I think that's he first started out as Power Man.
Man, I love that series.
Yeah, that's for sure.
You guys watch that series?
Dude, yeah.
Yeah, I finished it.
It's awesome.
It's so good. Best one so far, I think.
Yeah.
Me too. Yeah, I thought so too. It was just so well done. Music was awesome.
Those are real artists,
too. Dude, they had the Wu-Tang Clan in there.
Long live the chief.
And Redman.
Method Man.
Method Man.
Meth.
Method Man.
Fucking meth. Gave him his jacket.
That was so good.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
A camo jacket.
Yeah.
And everyone's wearing the jackets with bullet holes in them.
Yeah.
God, that so cool. Was cool. Yeah.
It was really a great show.
I thought that Diamondback's outfit at the end looked kind of like a Lego outfit.
He did look like a Lego, man.
That was his costume from the comic, though.
Yeah, I know.
It was pretty
accurate. I had to appreciate it on that level.
Hammer Tech.
Yeah,
yeah, I really was waiting for it to fuck up at some point.
Yeah, why like, did it not fuck up?
That's where they messed up. They definitely should have had it like
at one point just like fizzle out or something.
Yeah, just like a puff of black smoke.
Yeah,
and the lights.
That's
go
how
out.
Hammer Tech works.
It
that's
is.
How it rolls. Okay, well, yeah, Rhino's cool.
Rhino was awesome.
Rhino's awesome, dude. I was really let down. Like that, at the end of Spider-Man 2, you know, the best scene was when Rhino showed up.
Yeah.
I always thought that was fucking cool. And it looked like it was going to be like a brand new beginning, you know, and then they don't make any more.
And then that's
Let's
it.
Let's just make these two.
But,
well, they're doing the Sinister Six in those movies, but it doesn't look like
I mean, we're getting Shocker. We're getting Shocker.
I'm happy.
Yeah.
Shocker
I'm
and Vulture,
excited.
I think that's a good start.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to do Sinister Six right,
I just can't believe we're getting Shocker. Like,
I know. That was
shocked.
Shocking.
It's very shocking.
It was very
Consider
shocking.
Consider me
Let's
shocked.
Do my pot.
I need my quilt. Give me my quilt. I need my quilt.
I'm cold.
Right now.
I don't care
so
that
shocked.
It's 110 degrees in New York summer. I need my quilt.
Need my clouds.
It keeps me from being electrocuted by my
The kinetic recoil really is a killer. Okay, well, let's end this on that note. I have some recommendations. Okay, let's cap this thing off with some recommendations. What were they again? Graven's Last Hunt.
That was great. One of them.
It was pretty good.
I thought it was really poetic. Just really.
It kind of had this really weird tone to it.
It did. It was a different tone.
Can it be any suggestion?
Yeah, have to just be whatever. Really? There's something that sticks out to you or something you really liked.
Okay, Hard Boiled.
Great movie.
Movie?
Are you talking about the book? Oh, there's a movie.
Yeah, they made a movie of Hard Boiled?
Fuck yeah, dude.
What?
Oh, you're talking about the Frank Miller comic?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a good book, but... They made a movie, and I don't think they're related.
The movie, they have the same title, but the movie's nothing about it.
Right.
Nothing.
Okay.
It's not a cyborg or anything.
But it's
like
a really cool movie.
Oh, man. That graphic novel was. I love that artist, and I love that.
Yeah, I got that graphic novel too. It is.
Yeah, you have the actual book. I have it. I just ran onto it again on my hard drive, so I was just looking through it. And
really, like, intricate. That artist, I keep forgetting his name, did Rusty the Boy Robot.
Yeah, I'll look
really like weird stuff in it though. Weird dystopian future.
I don't think
stuff.
I ever finished it, but yeah, it was very.
It's pretty short too.
It really detailed illustrations.
Maybe I did finish it. I can't remember.
You got your recommendations, Donnie?
I would recommend Luke Cage.
Series? Oh yeah, Netflix series. Definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yes.
Of course.
There's another Spider-Man. Oh, New Ways to Die.
Jeff Darrow.
Okay, Jeff Darrow.
He's very, very talented. Sorry, didn't mean to.
No. New Ways to Die, I think, is cool. That's a good Spider-Man series.
Yeah.
I have the actual issues.
New Ways to Die.
That's where Anti-Venom shows up.
Yeah. Mr. Negative.
Yeah, it has like a. Mr. Negative. It has a lot of characters in it. It has Bullseye, has Scorpion.
Speaking of Sinister Six, there was a run of arcs where he would fight each villain, and there was like one like Lizard was Shed. You hear that?
Yeah,
and that was
that.
Awesome. And then they did one of the Rhino, and that was awesome. And it was just one arc after another, and they were all connected at the end somehow. I think like there was a reason why each one of these former Sinister Six members were going after Spider-Man, doing this crazy shit. Because Lizard almost took over the city and shit. With all those lizards coming out of the sewer.
He's always doing that.
Almost turned everybody.
He's always doing
that. The art was so good.
Yeah, that was Ramos. Is his name Ramos?
Yeah, it was.
He did the Wolverine run.
Yeah,
I think in
he
Civil
did.
War.
Civil War. Yeah.
Oh. He was chasing after Nitro.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Man, that artist is like
I
really
love,
out there.
Love that artist.
Really cool.
Who exaggerated.
He's one of my
style.
Favorites. Like his style is just so, like it emotes so much.
Yeah, very fluid.
And. It's nice to look at.
Yeah, I
but
really
Shed
like
was awesome. Yeah. Rhino's story was awesome because it involved his daughter.
Didn't they have a Vulture one too? Can we talk about Vulture again?
No,
I don't know. I think they did have a Vulture, but it was a few. It wasn't all of them. It wasn't six of them, but it was a few of them.
Yeah, it's
hitting
back.
Spider-Man one after the other for some reason. And then like you know, and also a little tidbit that I learned with Sinister Six, Doc Ock started it because. He could never beat Spider-Man, so we want to get them involved.
Mm-hmm.
And none of them could agree to do it together because everybody wanted the glory of killing Spider-Man. So they fought Spider-Man one at a time. And Spider-Man
Idiots.
Beat them all, and they mocked him for it.
Idiots. That's why I like Spider-Man. Don't make fun of him and shit.
They each wanted their shot, basically.
I like that.
Alright, well.
You too.
Yeah.
It's done. Spider-Man
villains.
I went in the bag.
Cha-ching.
End.